Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about making sense of everything. It makes no sense what we do in our rooms. It makes no sense to put up with what we put up with. So let's walk through some of the steps today. Electronics, very high resolution electronics. A lot of you know I've been out of electronics for probably 15, 20 years, but we set up our new studio here. I had to get into the marketplace and start buying stuff. And after a 15, 20 year hiatus, and I was pretty active in it, probably owned $1 million in gear during my lifetime. So I had a pretty good handle on amplification. I was a Class A guy all the way. Had a pretty good handle on the analog side of things. Never really got into turntables too much, but did have one originally when I got started. But there's been a huge improvement. I haven't noticed so much in amplification. It's always been pretty good, especially the Class A stuff. Speakers have come a long way. I got to be honest and say that cables have really improved. Power cables, interconnects, dramatic changes since I was, you know, in the gear game, so to speak. But when you look at the improvements of our gear today, it's really quite astounding. You know, the speaker's still the weakest link in the whole chain, but they've improved quite a bit too. I mean, I bought some speakers, you know, in the last 6 months that sound excellent. Of course, they're placed in really good rooms too. So we take this digital box, because everything's a box, right? We take this digital box, which is very high resolution, and we stick it in a low resolution room. A very low resolution room. Does that make any sense? It really doesn't. You know, there should be some linearity and some coherence in thought to that. It's like taking a Ferrari on a trail ride. You wouldn't do that. Well, some people would. But you wouldn't do that because the Ferrari is not set up to handle trails. It's a flat surface car with lots of speed and suspension to handle those kind of situations. Well, that's what we're doing with our gear. We're taking our Ferrari, which is the gear, and we're putting it on in a trail ride, which is the room. So you have high resolution sources in a low resolution container. If we break the distribution of sound quality down to 50% gear and 50% room, we got to do a lot of different things. We got to do a lot of different steps to get the resolution of the room up to the resolution of the gear. So we want to improve the attack and decay rates in low frequency. That takes treatment. We want to lower reverb times, mids and highs. That takes treatment. We want to increase in speech intelligibility indexes, which is defined as how many words in a 10-word sentence we can hear. We do that through treatment. We've got three sound fields to treat, and a lot of people don't understand that, and that's very important. Remember, we've got width, we've got height, and we've got length, right? So we have three sound fields, and to compound all of these problems, each of these sound fields has a different frequency and amplitude of problem. So we have to assign the appropriate treatment to those areas of the room that have those frequency and amplitude of problems. For low frequency management, we're usually looking at a 50% surface area coverage. So if we have a wall that's 8 foot, we're really looking for at least 4 feet of surface area coverage. Ours are 5 by design. And there's reasons for that, because that's the critical mass you need to accumulate to have a very big audible impact. We're so used to living with distortion that we have to treat a large surface area to bring the resolution up to a point where we go, wow, that's great. That's better. That's definitely different. So when we're dealing with highs, middle and highs, it's about the same ratio. We have a wall that's got a reverb issue, and we're going to cover that wall with 50% panels. Whatever that is. Those are general rules of thumb we go by from doing this for years and years and years. So we've come up with those ratios. Elevate the resolution of the room. Don't deviate. Don't use plants as diffusers. Don't use couches as absorbers. Don't use lamps as diffusers. They're not. Okay, they're not a tool designed to do that. So don't deviate. Elevate your thinking. Elevate the treatment process. Elevate the whole resolution of the room. And try and match the resolution of the gear. You won't get there, but the journey is definitely worth the effort. Makes no sense. Let's try to make some sense out of taking this high-resolution source that we have today and sticking it in a low-resolution room. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.